you're gonna wanna witness it. So bad when you think about the dead. Compared to only 60 beats by the cause. Nothing more, nothing less. Ain't nothing but it's written by the cause.
Outro at the end.
I know.
I was like, okay, who's ready to come in?
I answer the phone lines, right?
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to the caller on the line who thought I was your secretary.
Oh, wow.
When did she get a secretary? Why doesn't Juan have a secretary?
Oh, he's so stupid.
Woo! So what's our first topic? Sinbad will be right back with you, babe.
Okay, we need to get into what is the craziest thing ever said to you or asked to you during sex? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I like that topic.
Yeah. I saw this on Twitter, you know, in Twitterverse, and people were just going ham. And I was like, you know what? Let me ask that to the callers and to the panel. So what would you say, Seneca?
The craziest thing asked or said. I don't think I've been asked the craziest thing. That's the thing. And I don't think that the craziest thing has ever been said to me. But, because to me it's kind of like, I don't want to call it regular stuff, although it's, you know.
Yeah, you're pretty wild, girl.
I know, it was pretty steamy and stuff. But, I had someone have me to pretend like I ran a radio station and they wanted to get their music heard and played on the station. So that was pretty interesting.
Oh, wow, that's really a nice little role play there.
And I think the craziest thing that was asked and said at the same time was probably a long, long, long time ago, somebody called me a bitch real angrily during sex.
Right.
And it just kind of made me snap into, like, time's out.
I'm getting dry now.
Whoa. I mean, sometimes it's okay. You know, it just depends on the context. But the way he said it, I was like, this. You know, like, how long have you been holding that bitch in there?
Right, exactly.
You know?
Like, he's mad about something that happened in the past.
Mad about something.
Yeah, now, I mean, you ask him, if you, like, asking me if I'm your bitch while you stroking, then, you know, and I'm like, yeah, you know, something like that. But if you just, like, bitch, and I'm, hold on, wait a minute.
Right.
Oh.
Right.
You know.
And then I would have to say having a, this is so hilarious. Okay, so. Oh, my gosh. Okay, so I had a wig on once.
Yeah.
well, I wear those quite often, but I had a wig on once. And the sex position was like doggy style.
Yeah. Oh, Lord.
Woo! Okay, so I had to hold my wig in the frame because it motherfucking kept trying to pull my wig off, but I was like, oh my God, I don't want to stop. You know what I'm saying? But it was just like, please, whatever you do. Okay, ladies, have you guys ever taken out a quick weave and you didn't wash your hair just as of yet and you may have had, like, a little bit of glue on your hair still, so you just throw a wig on?
Yeah.
Yeah. I was fighting to keep that mug on. Like, please don't come off.
Yeah, that would be crazy because it's like, even if the guy will forget that you have a wig on, if they know and they just get to pulling in the hair and it's like, oh, my God, don't do that. Don't pull on my hair.
Ugh, I hate when they touch, like, the bottom of your hairline. I'm like, ugh! Get off my stocking cap.
You're so stupid. That's why, like, now, since I'm wearing my own hair now, it's kind of like, okay, it makes it more exciting, but for a while, I was all about wigs and the extensions. Even if when I would get my extensions put in, don't be pulling. You might pull it out, rip it out. Let you get to snatching and pulling. It's like, hold on, you got to be gentle. You can't be grabbing on you like that.
But even with your natural hair, it's for some odd reason, they always want to take a shower. Like when you wear your natural hair, you just flat iron your shit like bone straight, perfect. It's like,
hold on, I'm black. I can't just be getting in the shower like that. And expecting you think mine will turn into a fro once I get out. Like nothing will be sexy. About
that might be the craziest thing asked of me is to take a shower with my brand new hairdo.
Yeah, that is not smart. We just spent hours upon hours in the shop to get it how it is. To just get in the shower and wash all that hard work and stuff run away. Don't ever do that, fellas. That's a huge no-no when it comes to hair and sex.
Huge, huge no-no.
Oh, but girl, let me tell you this, and I can't make this shit up.
Okay.
The craziest thing ever, and I would say, not necessarily said to me, but more like a said over me, was this guy I met. And this was
this is going to get good.
This is a guy I met, and me and my mom was at, like, this PTA meeting at my little brother's school. This was back when he was in elementary school. Okay. And they had this fine teacher that he was fine. I was like, ooh, hello. So, you know, I flirted. He flirted back. Then we exchanged numbers. And then we went out on a date a few days later on a Saturday. And then, you know, went back to his place. You know, we were each other. We, you know, starting to get it popping, right?
Mm-hmm.
And mind you, he's Muslim, okay? He's Muslim. Tell me why in the middle of the act he starts praying.
What?
No bullshit. And you know they do their own little prayer. You can't understand what they're saying. Like I could not. It was the weirdest thing. Like he's hitting it from the back, and then all of a sudden he gets speaking in whatever language he's speaking in. I'm just like, it was the weirdest shit ever. Like I could no longer get back into the act after that. It was so weird.
Yalla, Habibi, Allah.
Yeah, he was doing all of that while he was choking. And that was the first and last time we had sex. I said, I don't know what this man said over me. I can't do this.
Oh my gosh. I know what the craziest thing was. But this was not during sex because he was not getting any from me. So this guy kept trying to get some. And I kept trying to tell him, I'm an adult, so if I want to give it to you, I will. But by all means, I really just want to chill and just watch this movie real quick. So he just kept at it. And then he wanted to, like, climb on top of me, so I put my hand over my crotch area, you know, as if to say, no, you know what I'm saying? Like, no, like, get off me, no. So he just kept saying, what you got there? So I was just like, get off of me, you know, chill out. He's like, what you got there, a big boy or a little boy? And I was like, eh?
Like, what?
What did you just say? And then he just looked at me, and I said, did this motherfucker just ask me if I had a big dick or a little dick? Because what he said after that was, do you have a big boy or a little boy? It don't matter. No, he said it don't matter afterwards. And he did not look like he was ashamed that I heard him, or he, I think maybe he was so out of it that he didn't realize he said that shit. I just kind of like, you know, was like, I'm about to go. I knocked on my friend's door like, I'm about to go. I don't know what type of people y'all be having, you know, what type of friends y'all be having around here, but this whole double date thing is not working for me right now. So, see, the way my vagina is set up, I don't like gay men, so
Sorry, you can't explore over here, buddy.
So that would have to be like the craziest thing. Let's go to our calls and see what crazy things they've done. Caller, you're live on Tasha's Taste. What up?
Hey.
Caller, are you there, caller?
You didn't get shy now, did you?
Nope, maybe so. Okay, we'll try another caller. And let's see here. Caller, you're on Tasha's Taste. Do you have something that you want to say about something crazy that was said during sex or asked of you during sex?
Oh, he asked you, did you have a big dick or a little dick? And he had a
he
dick?
Did.
Oh, man.
He did.
Wow. I thought the Jeff Fresh was going a little out of hand. You know what? That's not cool. Why would you ask a woman if she got a dick? I mean,
well, because I had my hand over my crotch and I was like, no. And so he thought I was
tranny?
Holding my dick.
He thought you was a tranny dog.
Yeah. Oh, here's a funny story. So I download Tango. Okay, so guys, for those of you who don't know, I was in the Windows market for 6 whole months and then some, maybe like a whole year. So I just recently got back to my Android, and I got Tango. So I'm going through my profile trying to update some stuff and posting some pictures, and as I'm updating my profile, I noticed that I'm listed as a male.
Whoa.
So all the pictures that I uploaded says Seneca updated his profile picture. I was like,
Demetrius to the bakery, Demetrius to the bakery.
Oh my gosh, I am so all woman. So I had to post a picture that showed it.
Yeah.
Well, it didn't really show any body parts, nothing like that, but you know.
Yeah.
Not following Seneca on Tango.
No,
might.
Follow me on
Tango.
Tango
is like a, is that like a dating site, right? Or a dating app?
No, it's, you know, it's too many damn apps. It's just strictly for calls, text messages. You can play music and send people like fireworks across it. And like if you download it, everybody in your call log more than likely has Tango.